a deep breath now as we come into our hearts. And dropping out of the mind, where the mind's constantly thinking in duality, we bring our focus to our heart chakra or heart center. Thank you for coming. This is your time for you to connect with your higher self, your oversoul, your entire being in all dimensions. For when we meditate, we connect heaven and earth in our hearts. It balances us, clears us from physical ailments of stress, and even clears our thoughts. Like a gentle air, as we imagine a beautiful blue or aqua, like an ocean, a calm ocean. Stillness. As when we are still, we open the dimensions to other aspects of ourselves. And now we see a blue sky. As a bird flies past, representing freedom, peace, and focus. As we see the clouds gently going by, white, fluffy clouds. Hold certain shapes. There is symbology in the clouds with the shapes they are, revealing pictures of what's going on in the consciousness. As air is water, clouds are water. Particles, either closer or further apart in the molecular structure. And because they are water, they hold consciousness. Just like our ocean and rivers. The ocean and the rivers that are near you and where you live in your part of the world holds consciousness for the people and for the plants and the soil and the animals in those areas, which is why there's different water patterns and cycles, creating different thoughts and consciousness patterns for the people. Which brings us all the different countries and their diversity of culture, their different ways of thinking and beliefs. Comes from the water around them. And water water is the essence of life. If a planet has water, it has life. We all came from water and still contain a lot of water in our system. And one of the most powerful healing techniques for you is to hold a glass of water, have an intent, and then drink the water, and the water will go to parts of the body that are in need of the positive change. For it works with our cells that hold memory and life force. So let's focus on our glasses of water just for a moment, and without holding them, just focus on the glass and put an intent of something you'd like to receive when you next drink your water. It could be love or healing, or to fix an area of your body if you have a sore foot, for example. Put a thought and send it to your water. And now, as we visualize our beautiful planet Earth in the center of our circle in a hologram, just floating, we see all the water moving around it in currents and tides, swishing around, affected by the moon and other planets as we rotate on our axes. You can see waves rolling into planets in patterns of seven as the tides go up and down around the planet. Every 11 hours, everything is mathematical. There's a sequence in consciousness. We have seven seas on our Earth at present. And when the Earth was created, it was the one sea, one ocean, and then was divided into land and ocean on the second day of Genesis, called Gondwana land. Over time, thousands of millions of years, the land divided into two land masses, parting the seas, called Atlantis and Lemuria, a continent at the North Pole and a continent at the South Pole, bringing the masculine and the feminine to the planet. Over time, the land masses divided like a jigsaw puzzle coming apart into now the seven land masses or continents. On this seventh day of Genesis, we are at a threshold of entering the new kingdoms. The new paradise Earth is coming. And over time, we will have 12 land masses and 12 seas as we open up the Earth's chakra systems to 12 as we are evolving to 12. Over millions of years, of course. So the water consciousness is changing, creating the lands to part and divide for the people, for the species and kingdoms. As the sea evaporates into the clouds, and 3 feet above your sea level is the strongest air, where we have the first stage of evaporation called osmosis. This air is the best to breathe in for your health. It cures many ailments as it contains still all the minerals of the sea. The air is slightly thicker just above the sea level, which is a realm where many of the elements live. Even lying on the sand, you will receive, if the wind blows the sea breeze towards you, this beautiful air. As you lay upon the crystalline sand, as sand is made of crystal, and at this time of year we have the beautiful summer giving us a chance to lay on the sand, usually on our backs, because the back of our chakra system is our past. We heal our past and let it go as we sunbake. But all in moderation, as at different times of the day are the different rays of the sun. The different rays of the sun are light frequency bands of the colors of the rainbow. Certain times of the day might be better for you. According to what your chakras need. For your chakras are portals or windows of consciousness. They come in through the front and out the back generally. So the front of our chakras is our future. Let's connect to our guardian angel, who wishes to place a beautiful robe of color rainbow around you, to heal your chakras if they need it, to gently lift off any debris if you've been carrying any in the backs of or sides of the chakra, or if there's blockages of darker colors at the front. This beautiful rainbow robe will adjust your chakras to suit your perfect higher self. See the rainbows moving around you. And as you breathe in, you see your rainbow chakras expanding with color, like jewels in the lotus. As each chakra sits in a lotus, the lotus petals indicate times of enlightenment. The more petals that are open, the more experiences you've had at being enlightened. And when you see this all full and clear, radiant, we then bring our focus back to the earth in the center of our circle and ask for rainbow light healing for our beloved planet, Earth Starship. The planet we are all riding on through the galaxy. Each country represents a chakra as it turns. Chakra is balanced and alight and clear, you will see a white light appearing around the globe. For all colors, make white. As we thank Mother Earth for giving us life here, in the physical realm, and for creating for us through our parents, our physical being, which is the temple of our soul during this incarnation. And we are to look after our bodies with fresh water, air, and good food, which Mother Earth provides all the time. And now we zoom into the earth and see beautiful forests filled with birds, greenery, as we walk into one with the sunlight coming through the treetops. We find a healing spot on the leaves, near flowers, or perhaps a waterfall. And we lay on the mossy grass or leaves that are so large in this Amazon forest. And we lay down to nurture ourselves, receive all the codes from nature, from the carbon monoxide, see the flowers around you, tiger lilies, all sorts of colourful flowers that let off a frequency and a scent that is of a healing, aromatic perfume. Of your body that have been sore, ill, light up these areas as you allow a healing ray of green to touch them. healing your beautiful heart, the Emerald Heart. For this chakra is the one that is your center and balances all the other chakras. It does most of the work for your body, balancing the hot chakras below with the cool chakras above, the left flame of feminine pink with the masculine blue flame, and your future before you with your past behind you, creating a six-pointed Merkaba star in the heart. Your Merkaba is what they call in the Bible the chariot, is the vehicle you travel if you astral travel. This Merkaba star enlarges and spins. Part of your soul travels in it. That's connected to the golden cord. Whereas your being remains behind, connected to the silver cord that connects to the earth, the mother cord or the father cord. And see your beautiful Merkabas surrounding your heart or your body. If you are expanded, like a pearlescent crystal white gold. And while you are still laying in the forest, some fairies come and place flowers on you. One on your third eye, the palms of your hands, your feet, and anywhere else that needs healing, with a different flower. Once the healing is done, we thank the fairies and the forest and stand up and walk on now to another part of the earth. We go to a mountain this time, a strong earth representation, where this mountain is tall with a white snowy peak. Possibly in the Himalayas. And as we walk to the mountain with our guides along a rocky path, we come to a cave in the mountain. And as we go in, we notice our aura lights up the cave. We haven't seen our aura do this, but around your aura is a film of light that we don't normally see with physical eyes, but can with our inner eye. As it lights up the room in the cave, we take a seat and we see that the cave is amethyst, beautiful purple crystal, glistening points all around us. As one of your closest guides appears and sits opposite you on the other rock. This guide has been with you for a long time. This guide is from the light, could be a friend or someone you know that has passed on, or it could be a guide like Merlin, a master, an extraterrestrial. Any fears to do with meeting the guide are just removed. If there's any interference of fear, they get cleansed in the purple cave. Till you see this light being before you. Someone who smiles at you and has wanted you to meet them. Personal guide. Who passes you a very important scroll for you to open later to do with your ancestry. Note the colour of the ribbon around it. It'll be significant. As we say thank you to our guide and we step out of the cave, putting the scroll in our pocket or bag, and walk now to somewhere else on the earth with a beautiful ocean, a tropical ocean. With palm trees, with coconuts, white sand, where crystals and shells and bits of coral wash up on the shore at your feet. The sun is shining, and there's a beautiful warm breeze. Frangipanis and hibiscuses grow. You could hear music, singing, like Lemurian tones, when the earth was in a high vibration. And you remember this feeling. When you lived in a time of peace and awareness. Someone comes before you, walks towards you. Someone you knew in Lemuria that is alive on the earth plane now. A friend, a member of family, or a soulmate. You embrace with this person and receive healing as your codes remember this time of love. And how you were and felt when you lived in pure fifth dimension, oneness. This person tells you that it's coming soon, this time, where the planet will again remember the awakening. This is the new earth as we return back to our wholeness, where our cells become alive again, coated with starfire, like an effervescent lemonade runs through the body. Bubbles awaken the cells of life. You thank this friend as you both turn to the sea and see a beautiful crystal washes up for both of you. At your feet, one each, a gift from Mother Ocean, who still holds the codes of Lemuria, Atlantis, Egypt as it was, Avalon, Ouroboria, and all the sacred times. You pick up this crystal and hold it to the sun and see inside it a flame. A spirit lives in this crystal. As you see a rainbow flame of light, a part of you that was left behind in Lemuria returns now. As you breathe in this flame and it comes out of the crystal and into your heart, a part of you returns. You may wish to keep the crystal, or you may wish to return it to the sea for another time. If you wish to keep it, you can bring it and place it on your home altar or somewhere in your garden for a while. As we walk from the beach, thanking our friend for the remembrance, and we walk now to the clouds where we started, flying up on the back of a beautiful bird, either an eagle or a dove. The bird soars up to the clouds as we ride the wind, the jet streams through the dream lines, and land on a white fluffy cloud. Spirit receives light, wisdom, and information from God connection, as we are a hologram or a part of the whole. As we thank the sun above us, and then we fly back down to the ocean temple and merge again in alignment with our bodies, thanking our guardian angels for the journey and thanking yourselves for being here. For your soul, giving time to your soul and to heal and clear your body, which you are already. We just pick up bits and pieces on the journey. You are already fully whole, complete, and in perfect design when you were created. We just forget. Breathing in as we give thanks for this day, for being alive on the planet in this time. Our life is a gift. Blessings and namaste.
Namaste.